bezobrazno zgodan ili lijep kao grijeh, riječi su kojima započinje gotovo svaka rečenica o hollywoodskom glumcu Paulu Walkeru. Ovog Amerikanca mnogi su na početku karijere uspoređivali s Bradom Pittom. No ipak je to bilo samo zbog izgleda, budući da mu je uloga u filmu Brzi i žestoki još uvijek vrhunac karijere. Kako sam se ipak prepala da na intervju ne bude ljepši od mene, prvo sam morala svaku sitnicu dobro pročekirati.
I was just eating strawberries. Do you have something on my teeth?
No, you teeth are good. They get strawberries?
Yes.
All right, good.
Ok, sada smo mogli krenuti na posao i koncentrirati se na ono što ga je ipak najviše proslavilo, njegovu vanjštinu.
How much luck did help in your life? I mean, magazine people put you in the 50 most beautiful people in the world. What do you think? Did it help in your career?
No, I don't think it helps anything.
No?
No.
No.
Because you know what, you're in it one year, and you're not in it the next.
I think that you're going to be all your life there.
You're forgotten about in a year, 2 years.
No, ova skromnost ipak je bila samo taktika zavaravanja protivnika kako bi namamio od mene još koji kompliment. Kada je to i dobio, Walker je već bio puno realniji što se tiče posla na račun svoje ljepote.
Maybe from a marketing standpoint, the people that are counting, you know, tickets, and they take all those things into consideration. Didn't used to once be that way, but unfortunately, all that matters today. You know, the more your face is, I think, in a magazine or a tabloid, I think that probably ups your marketability.
Tako vam je to danas u Hollywoodu. Više se priča o skandalima, manje o dobrim ulogama. No novopečene glumačke skandaluše tipa Lindsay Lohan teško da će se jednog dana moći pohvaliti karijerom jedne Meryl Streep.
I think majority of them probably like it. That's why they're there. And so they should be there. But the ones that aren't, generally are the people that don't care for it too much.
So you hide your personal life?
I try to.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Are you successful in that?
Sometimes.
Bolest zvanu hollywoodsko žutilo kritizira i njegova ljubavnica iz Brzih i žestokih, Jordana Brewster. Danas je to ipak uzelo maha više no ikad.
Some people think that, you know, any press is good press, so that's one way to go. I think, and those people, if they can stay sane and do that, that's good for them, but I can't stay sane. Like if I was in the press all the time and going out and clubbing and dating a bunch of people, I think I would go a little crazy and I wouldn't be able to keep my sense of self.
Ova mlada glumica nerijetko je surađivala s miljenicima tabloida. Posljednja je bila uloga s Michelle Rodriguez, koja je već 3 puta bila uhićena zbog vožnje u pijanom stanju, pa je tako prošle blagdane umjesto na setu provela u zatvoru. Michelle je inače otvoreno priznala svoju ljubav prema alkoholu, opijatima i istom spolu.
Michelle says exactly what's on her mind, which is very refreshing and I really admire that about her, so it's always fun to be around.
You were also in the Mr. and Mrs. Smith. At that period, they were like all the world was obsessed with Brad and Angelina. What do you think? Did it affect on the acting then or something on their personal life? Or
I think no. I think that she's untouchable because she's so stunning and so good and talented. I think she has so much talent to back it up that it doesn't matter. She can do anything.
How would you compare her to Michelle Rodriguez? I think maybe before, when she was younger, she was also a little bit edgy.
I think, I don't know, I guess she spoke her mind, and so in that way they're very similar, and it seemed like she didn't really care what people thought.
Jordana Brewster uz glumačku se karijeru može pohvaliti i diplomom prestižnog sveučilišta Yale. Iako su joj predviđali zavidnu manekensku budućnost, nije htjela ići tim putem.
Too competitive. Acting is competitive enough. I couldn't deal with modeling.
Možda joj je samopouzdanje ipak malo više poraslo nakon nekoliko uloga s Vinom Dieselom i Paulom Walkerom.
Would you choose to be Paul Walker or Vin Diesel's girlfriend?
I think I would have to say Paul because I could never imagine being Vin's girlfriend. And Paul's always been such an open, sweet, like child, young, like he's very, very young at heart.
Nije ni čudo što je na ovog ljepotana palo pola hollywoodskog ženskog roda. Iako je s bivšom partnericom dobio dijete, nije ostao s njom. No toga ni najmanje ne muči.
I don't know, not if I was being honest with myself.
Yeah?
Yeah, but guys sometimes have a hard time doing that.
How do you imagine the perfect girl for you?
The perfect girl? Natural. Hard-headed, confident, spontaneous.
And the look, is it important?
Yeah, of course.
Ha, 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 ha.
doesn't it with everybody?
Well, somebody says it's not.
They're lying.
Yeah.
No, s istim smješkom se i ne prisjeća baš početka svoje glumačke karijere. Poker je naime nekada davno bio zvijezda sapunice Mladi i nemirni, koja je u Santa Barbaru bila najveći američki hit.
I'm telling you, Ryan, you better back off and leave the kid alone. You've already brought enough grief into her life.
Brandon, why don't you just say what is really on your mind?
Oh, and what's that supposed to mean?
Do you think it's more difficult after soap operas to become like a serious actor? That you have to try more or not?
No, because I did that for a year, I think maybe a year and a half. I was right out of high school. And it was fun for a little bit. And then when it was done, I didn't really care. And the last thing I thought is that I'd come back eventually to make movies again. That was the furthest thing from my mind. I wanted to be a marine biologist, that's what I went to school for.
Amatersko sapuničarenje na kraju ga je ozbiljno poguralo na velika vrata. No vjerovali ili ne, u Hollywoodu je ipak sve moguće.
Just by chance or just circumstances, someone remembered me from when I was younger and asked me to come in and read for a show. I still don't know or remember how he managed to track me down. And then I got one job. It was Pleasantville. I thought I'd make one movie and be done. Well, now it's like 10, 12 years later and I'm still making movies, so I guess this is what I'm supposed to be doing.
Eto, pitanje gdje bi danas bile naše zvijezde sapunica da su se rodile u Americi. No do tada barem se i mi možemo pohvaliti da smo u nečem slični s Amerikom. Imamo gotovo isti broj zvijezda, skandala, wannabe talenata, a zamislite, cijela Hrvatska veličine kao jedan kvart u LA-u. Kakve li ironije!